Alright. So, the next round just started. The timer should be almost perfect. We have on the left side again Tobias Thesing playing his Ninetales deck. We already featured in round 2, I believe. Or round 1. And he's playing against Tamau Cameron, the last British national champion. And Tamau is playing a very interesting deck. He's playing the Xerneas Break deck. I already told you about that during our metagame analysis. It just builds on Xerneas with Geomancy, powering up this Pokemon with energy. And the more energy he has in play, the more damage Xerneas Break does with Lifestream later on. So basically he has unlimited damage. He could pretty much one-shot any Ninetales that comes in his way. So we'll see if he'll be able to do that, or if Ninetales will be able to put on so much pressure that before Tamau can even set up, that Tobias will be able to win this one. Whoever wins this next round will be able to tie into top cut if he so chooses. So the pressure is on for this round. We see Tamau going first. This is quite good for the Xerneas deck, although with the Xerneas opening you don't mind going second because you can attack with Geomancy that way anyway. And he opens with a Bridget, doesn't even need to Tabulele for that, and it looks like he's eyeing up 3 Xerneas. So as you can already see, this deck basically just tries to stream Xerneas Breaks over and over again. Yeah, he's also checking his price cards. Good players usually just check their price cards real quick to see if anything important is priced. I think in this deck you might check for Xerneas Breaks, things like that, but there's actually nothing too huge that could be priced in this matchup. There are no certain tech cards that Tamau plays, so I think he is fine. That deck was first played by Tamau and Joe Bernard at the North American Intercontinental Championship. They both didn't make day 2 there, but obviously they still believe in the deck, or at least Tamau still does, because he just plays this deck again. And yeah, he got the attachment active, but now he just had to pass, but actually there's nothing more you want to do on the first turn, so I guess his first turn was fine. Tobias on the other hand opens perfectly, like basically any game. This deck is just really consistent, so it's no wonder. With a Bridget, being able to search out a couple of Vulpix, Tapu Koko, and he probably just finishes turn with Icy Snow to search out maybe a couple of Lele, maybe a couple of Ninetales depending on his hand. Tobias Thesing will have the more slower approach this game, like basically all the time. He's trying to power up multiple Ninetales at once, so Tamau can knock out one threat and then destroy Tobias' whole board. But actually in this matchup it's not too easy to do that, or it's not the best thing, because Tamau also tries to set up his board before doing anything, and I think when Tamau sets up his board he is at the advantage because he can just stream knockouts on Ninetales while only giving up one prize. So I think if we see Tobias taking too long for a setup, Tamau will come out on top in the end. However, there are problems with the Xerneas Break deck. For example, streaming Xerneas is more difficult than it sounds. Xerneas Break needs 2 basic energies for his Lifestream attack, so doesn't sound like a huge requirement, but when you get knocked out every single turn, quickly turns into a problem sometimes. And you need strong draws to kind of just keep up the speed. That's also why he plays the Oranguru, because this deck obviously loses due to not being able to stream Xerneas in the late game when you get end down by your opponent, and Oranguru just kind of makes the Xerneas deck more end proof than it would be without it. So the Xerneas deck looks like it's very well thought out. I'm not sure, but in Indianapolis they also played Max Elixir to kind of speed up the process, but I'm not sure if they still play that. Alright, we'll just get the decklist real quick to confirm what exactly they're playing. But as we all know, Tobias is not playing his Octillery, just straightforward Ninetales, powering through his opponents up until now with his laid back style of game. But I'm really not sure we can pull through with the strategy this game too. Thanks. So actually Tamar's decklist looks really simplistic. He just cut all those techs that they played before in Indianapolis. He only plays the Oranguru, 3 Xerneas and 3 Tapulele, as well as 3 Xerneas Break. That's all his Pokemon. However, he teched 2 Enhanced Hammer, which is probably really good against those Garbodor Drampa decks, maybe even the Sidra Ninetales, all those decks that rely on special energies. And he also maxed out on Max Elixirs, while only playing 12 Fairy Energy with Geomancy, which might be questionable, but it works for him up until now, apparently. And of course you need Max Elixirs to get going more quickly, because you only gain 2 energies per turn with Geomancy, and 3 if you assume that you're attaching each turn. He also plays 2 double colorless energies. Those are just nice because they provide more energies than Xerneas, than fairy energies, but they also power up the Xerneas attack, because Livestream deals damage for each energy, not for each basic or fairy energy. So it kind of makes sense to play 2 double colorless energies as well. Here we saw Tobias abandoning his stall approach and just dealing 50 to the Xerneas Break. Xerneas Break has 150 HP, so he'll be able to knock out the Xerneas in 2 turns time. However, I don't know if he has that much time left. So yeah. Looks like it's still Tamar's turn. He has the enhanced hammer that I'd already talked about, so he's able to discard the energy of the Ninetales, which could come up big, because now Tobias isn't able to power up Ninetales on the bench while dealing damage with the active one. So quite nice enhanced hammer in this situation. What Tamar wants to do now is probably get down another Pokemon play, maybe a Max Elixir or 2, and maybe evolve into Xerneas Breaks. A 5th Pokemon would be quite nice, so he just has another target for energies on the bench. He obviously wants to spread out the energy so your opponent can't just last another knockout one Pokemon with a lot of energies and reduce your damage output drastically that way. But it looks like he didn't draw into another Pokemon, so he's kind of forced to use Geomancy to power up his Oranguru and also his Xerneas Break with 50 damage on it. Counting the energies now, he has 9 energies in play at the moment. That's already 180 damage plus the choice band, 210. So next turn, if Tobias isn't able to remove energies out of play, Tamao will knock out Ninetales. The only way for Tobias, however, to remove energies from play is to knock out Pokemon, but he has no energies to play at all, and his one energy attack only deals 50 damage, which isn't enough to deal a knockout right now. So it looks like Tamao will be able to go into the prize lead next turn. Also, Tobias usually likes to put down choice bands on a lot of his Pokemon, however, in this matchup, these choice bands are kind of useless. I mean, he could knock out a Tapu Lele, but right now there are only non-EX Pokemon in play. So the prize trade seems to be really difficult for Tobias in this matchup, which is always what the Xerneas Break deck wants. It kind of banks on having a positive prize trade against those GX decks. That's all it does. And it also relies on the format being a bit slower than past formats, so it has enough time to set up. There were also variants of this deck in formats earlier this season, but all of those weren't too successful because overall they were just too slow. But right now it seems the format has slowed down enough for Xerneas to become a threatening deck. Now Tamao has a couple of more decisions. He has another Max Elixir. Looks like some more tool cards, an Ultra Ball, so he could get out another Xerneas Break, because the one he used to attack this turn will probably go down next turn. Preferably he would get down some XP shares this turn too, or an attachment at least. We're already with the Max Elixir, which is only natural because he has a lot of basic energies in play already. So within the Max Elixir is nothing special right now. But looking at his hand, I didn't see any basic energies or XP shares. So that could be a problem in the later turns. But for now, Tamao should be able to take two prizes off of that Decidueye, off of that Ninetales, and leave Tobias with, again, zero energies in play. But if Tobias finds a DCE here, he can at least knock out the active Xerneas Break and make it almost impossible for Tamao to respond with a knockout next turn. What Tamao could do is attach a DCE next turn, put down a Xerneas Break and attach a Joyous Band to knock out the Ninetales that'll knock out the active Xerneas Break. But we see if we can even draw into all that. For now, the big question is if Tobias even has a DCE. Preferably he would end down Tamao as well, because Tamao had a big hand and just played and just took two prizes. There we see the end. Tobias could also just draw an Aqua Patch, and if he has a Water Energy in the discard pile, that and the Water Energy would also be enough for him to knock out the active Xerneas with Ice Blade, which is definitely what he needs to do this turn. If he can't, he'll be way too far behind. So it's already come down to whiffing or not whiffing. So it looks like he has Aqua Patch and the basic energy. Now I don't know if there is a basic energy in the discard pile, but it looks like it. He's playing the Aqua Patch pretty confidently, and there it is. So at least he'll be able to keep up in the game. However, Tamao, as I already said, if Tamao has the cards to pull it off, he can respond with another knockout. And I think if Tamao is able to do that next turn, he will win the game, because there's basically no way for Tobias to knock out another Xerneas other than huge card combos that he can never realistically achieve with another end. So Tamao is thinking about what to promote. Right now he's conservatively promoting the Xerneas with one energy. So that makes me think his height might not be too great. If he had a Fairy Garden, he could just promote it like anything. But also if he had the means to knock out his opponent's Ninetales, he would probably just slam his Xerneas active that has already two energies attached to it. Now, however, I have to question if he's got it all. It looks like he doesn't. He could, however, play an Ultra Ball, get a Tapu Lele, and maybe a Sycamore. He only plays Sycamore, Bridget, and Lysander, and also 3M in his deck, so he can't grab cards like teammates. But we'll see if he gets what he needs after Sycamore. In case he whiffs this turn, I think he'll still be fine. He'll probably have to put up with another knockout from the Ninetales in that case. But he still should be in great shape, I guess, because there are still so many energies in play. But only assuming he gets the knockout. If he gets the knockout, the game is basically over. So yeah, looks like that's enough. Yeah, there are 7 basic energies in play, as well as a DCE plus choice band. So Xerneas Perk will be able to pick up the knockout on the Ninetales this turn. Tobias will need 2 aqua patches and an attachment to respond with another knockout, and I doubt he'll be able to get that if he wants to play N next turn. He would need to get really lucky to do that. So maybe Tamao's able to set up even further. Another Xerneas break would be great, just as an insurance. But he doesn't have anything else, just a knockout. For now, seems like that's fine too. But maybe Tobias just has the nuts and gets the knockout on his own Xerneas break plus an N. But just looking at the prizes, you just see, even if Tobias knocks out the Xerneas break, he still has 4 prizes to go. But Tamao can only attack twice, 2-shot the Ninetales, and be fine with it. I mean, he has so much time left, he only needs to knock out one more Ninetales, and Tobias still needs at least 3 turns after this one to close out the game, assuming he has everything. So right now, I think Tamao wins game 1. Actually, the more I think about this matchup, the worse it seems for Tobias. I mean, usually he is the slower deck, right now he can't really go with the slow approach, because then Tamao will just set up and roll over him. So yeah, what do you do at being Tobias? You have to feel kind of bad about that matchup. Also, if you lose this game, you have to win the next round. So the pressure is on. But Tobias wouldn't have made the top 22 of Europe this year if he couldn't deal with those kind of situations. So I'm sure he'll find a way to do something about it, but now it's just less enough a game since he just passed over to Tamau. Tamau really just needs an attachment or Zernius break. That would be basically same as game as well, because then you would have enough energy to play to just knock out the Ninetales, even if it is able to KO the active Zernius break. Obviously, Tamau doesn't have to license it, but he gets to draw with Oranguru, and we see our boy Oranguru still being the best card in the format. He just draws the license out of the one card from Oranguru. So there we go, Tamau wins game one. And we see. I don't think he needed to draw the license this turn actually, but I mean, now the game is over more quickly. It's nothing too bad. Tobias can be happy about that as well, I think. Maybe in the next games Tamau doesn't open quite as well as he did this game. But again, looking at his list, there's nothing that could go too wrong for Tamau. Actually, just playing pure consistency. Could maybe open with his two enhanced Tamas, but even those are useful in this matchup. So it's looking grim for Tobias. Needs to figure out a way to come back. And he definitely needs to do that by putting on pressure. But how do you put on pressure by dealing 50 damage per turn? It'll be hard. Let's look at their opening hands. Looks like Tamau is opening with a Lele. At least he has a supporter for next turn. He can play an Ultra Ball and get another Lele. So it's not opening completely dead, however. Of course you don't want to open with Tapu Lele. Especially going second. This just means you have one less turn of Geomancy if you don't hit Max Elixir, Fairy Garden on your first turn, as well as the Xerneas to put the Max Elixir on. So, yeah. We see what he can come up with on his first turn. Yeah, so Tobias just has a couple of minions, which is really not what he wants to see. Those two cards could very well be enough to give Tamau the perfect opening. As I already said, he basically only needs Fairy Garden, Xerneas, and then a Max Elixir plus attachment. He already is underway. Actually, I think even in this matchup, he doesn't even need to attack with Geomancy on the first turn, and he'll still be fine, because Ninetales is just so slow. It's not like that one turn will be so crucial. Unlike maybe against Vespiquen or against Gyarados, you don't really want to give them too many turns. But against a slow deck like Ninetales, there's no problem with whiffing a turn, missing a beat one or two turns. And Tobias' hand actually looks quite interesting. I think he has two aqua patches and he can discard two water energies with his Ultra Ball. So he might even get a very quick Ninetales by turn two. And again he goes for the Bridget. I wonder what Tobias is doing when Bridget is priced. It seems like he's playing Bridget all the time. Like, obviously it's what you want to do, but like, Tobias has it always. So, can't complain about that at least. However, in that matchup, you surely want to draw as good as you can. Can't afford to within this matchup too much, and there are two alpha patches coming down. However, is still powering up multiple Ninetales. Doesn't feel the need to put on too much pressure with one Ninetales, rather it'd rather power up two. I mean, that's fine as well. Tamao at least now gets Tapu Lele off, which he probably will go for a Bridget again. Grabbing three Xerneas, or maybe two Xerneas in the right room, depending on what he wants to go for. I think Tamao knows that he doesn't need to attack with Geomancy on the first turn. And it's better to just set up and maybe even take it a little bit slower rather than pushing his luck by playing a man or something like that. You don't really need to do that. I think Tamao knows he should win if he sets up, so he just wants to make sure that he does exactly that. Attached on pass. That's a solid turn one for him. Next turn he can surely attack with Geomancy. But now, interestingly enough, Tobias plays in his Cape Rope. Tamao quickly promoting his Xerneas with the energy. Looks like he's confident that it won't get knocked out. I mean, it is unlikely. But Tobias just Lysandering up the top of Lele again. Maybe it doesn't have too much. I don't know. I don't know what's going on. He took back the Lysander. Maybe it just had the wrong card in hand. I don't know what's going on. Does he even have a hand? Actually, it just looks like he has to go for the attack with full picks. Luckily, he plays three Tapu Lele, so he can grab another one to get himself a support the next turn, plus the Ninetales. So it looks like he really didn't have much. Alright, apparently Tobias already played Kukui, so of course he couldn't last enough. And Tamao just setting up his Xerneas, already getting down VCE, which is obviously great for him. And he should probably have a couple more turns to set up before Tobias puts on that much pressure. I mean, technically he could attack with a Blizzard Edge next turn, but knocking out a single Xerneas with one energy doesn't really force Tamao to respond immediately. So, Fairy Garden coming down and he goes for a Sycamore. Drawing into another Max Elixir. Obviously great, you want to draw into as many Max Elixirs as you can before the first Geomancy, because after that probability of hitting an energy off of an Max Elixir just decreases drastically, actually. So, yeah, you really want to draw into those mechs that exist before they are basically dead. So now, it'll be interesting to see if Tobias goes for the Blizzard Edge this turn, or if he'll just attack the bench like he did last turn. I mean, it's really hard to say. Tobias probably didn't test this matchup either. I mean, who really tests against Xerneas Break? Another advantage of this deck, nobody's really testing against it. So, you might catch some people off guard. Right now, Tobias probably trying to figure out what's the best line of play. And it's not really that obvious. I think a Blizzard Edge will be fine, because Tamao can't just attack with Lifestream next turn. Actually, he could do that, but it doesn't really benefit him, so yeah, he'd rather just set up with more Geomancers before he enters the Lifestream. A problem with Tamao's list is that he cut down on XP shares. He only pulls 2 XP shares. So that's also why we haven't seen a lot of those up until now. He really wants to see those XP shares, because when Xerneas are starting to get knocked out, you're not only losing Pokemon, but you're losing damage if you don't have XP share in play. And if you're losing damage and Pokemon, and you're not able to one-shot anymore, you won't win the game. So XP shards are very important to his strategy. And of course he wants to throw into them early, but he hasn't had too much success with that. Oh, that's actually a good question. Why is Tobias teasing Tobias S? Yeah. Oh, I was thinking about another Tobias there, I guess. You know, our teammate Tobias Mutkowski is always on my mind. Such a sweet boy. But there we go. There we have Tobias T. We all know Tobias teasing, so I hope that didn't didn't disrupt your line of thought. Yeah. Now he's Tobias T again. Obviously you can't confuse him with Tobias S, because but oh well, let's see. I don't even know whose turn it is right now. I think Tamao just used Geomancy and Lysanat up the Tapu Lele. Right. Alright, that's a decent play. Lysanat up the Tapu Lele, obviously great to stall. And he needs some more time in this match to win. But now he has enough energy in play. Right now he has enough energy in play to get a knockout next turn with a Choice Band. So it looks like he's fine. So, if you're Tobias, what are you doing now? I mean, I guess you can just deal 50 damage if you want to, somewhere on the bench. But then you open up your Ninetales to get knocked out next turn, so you don't want to do that. Instead, he's just retreating into top of Loco, waiting for a perfect situation to knock out one of Tomas there, and he has breaks. But in this stand-up situation, Tomas should always lose because he has GX and Tomas EX, and he discards resources to attack, but now he's in a crash. And also Tomas more attack is going up already. So, Tomas just sitting pretty. Yeah, he's got a Pokemon into play. More targets for energies, of course. Maybe after this second one, he'll hit one of those XP shares that he needs so desperately. Not so desperately, but it would be nice to hit them eventually. And I think if you're Tamar here, you can even just take an upper and a Tapu Koko even if it doesn't matter. I mean, what else are you going to do? You're basically fully set up. And Tobias is now under the pressure. He has to do something. He has to do something immediately. Basically, if he takes the knockout on the active right now, he just has to hope that Tamar with Choice Band Energy next turn. And even if Tamar with Choice Band Energy, doesn't mean that Tobias is in a winning spot. So you can just see how bad this matchup for the Ninetales is for the Ninetales player. But alright, I think Tobias is doing what he can. And right now the only thing he can do is trying to come up with a way to take knockouts without just getting response not KO'd right back.
But yeah, it's really not looking great for Tobias.
Yeah, it wasn't a joke about skin color, no. I mean, Tobias Minkowski is, of course, of black skin color, but of course I wasn't referring to that, because that would be inappropriate. Yep, we are 405 Masters. This is the biggest regional we have yet seen in Europe. A lot of players came here to get some early points for the 2018 season. And yeah, the funny thing is, the winner of this regional could even get his European invite before the rotation, because he already has 200 points then and he only needs another League Cup win. And League Cup started in August, so the winner of this event might get his invite even before the rotation, which is just ridiculous. But this is how things are right now. Tobias now came around to take the knockout. And Tamau just got enough energies in play to take a knockout with the choice band. He plays three choice bands, so it's likely that he'll hit one of them. He could also just hit another Max Elixir and then attach. That would basically be the same. Yeah, right now I can just attach from hand, I guess, and take the knockout that way too. So I'm pretty confident that he'll take a knockout this turn, and then it'll be just same as game one. Tobias is just sitting there, not knowing what he could even do, and waiting until he lost. No, it's not that bad, but yeah, it is. And now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 energies in play. Xerneas Break deals 220 damage, knocking out Alola Ninetales GX in one hit. And Tobias needs a lot of aqua patches to even take a knockout this turn.
four. He's nine. Come on.
Damn. I think these situations are always so bad because you already know Tobias is going to lose, but you still have to talk and talk and talk. Don't you guys want to tell me about your lives a little? Like, what is going on with you? Are you excited for tomorrow? Who are you rooting for in this match? Who are you rooting for in general, aside from Mark Lutz? Tobias Thesing is always looking very, yeah, you can just feel his pressure by looking at his facial expression. He's always suffering while playing the game. Actually, he's even suffering while he's winning. But this is just how players are when they are in the tank. They are unemotional. They are just focused, and this is how you should be as a top player in Europe and anywhere really. I know he might look confused, but guys, gotta be sure he knows what he's doing. Right now, he should know that he's not doing anything to win this game, no matter what he tries. But he's already down one game, so why not try? Always play until you lose. Never give up. That's also a very important life lesson you're learning from Tobias right here. Never give up. Always carry on. I mean, of course, you should scoop when you're tied in games, like 0-0. If Tamao wasn't up one game, then you shouldn't scoop. Then you should maybe scoop. But now, Tamao already won game one, so scooping doesn't make any sense. Other than to save time. To go do other things that are more productive. And I think that's another knockout on the 9 tails, leaving Tobias with 3 Tapu Leles and a Tapu Koko. Let's see if this Tapu Koko will be able to carry him all the way. I don't know if I'm leaning myself out of the window too much by saying I doubt it. And there we see Tobias picking up his cards. Tamao moves on to 6-1-1, now only a tie away from a day 2 top 32 spot. Great for Tamao, interesting. I really like to see Zernia's win. It's a really cool deck. And I think Tamao's list is perfect for this meta game, very straightforward and tacked out where it needs to be. And I think we might even see some more great things from him tomorrow. Right now he managed to beat Tobias Thesing, one of the German legends of the game. Not as legendary as Mark Lutz, of course, but legendary. Tobias actually was second at German Nationals 3 times. Was never able to get the first place, but he was second 3 times. So he's always been a very consistent player, and yeah. It's always great to see those guys on stream. But yeah, I think we can wrap it up right now. And as Ross Gilbert would say, grab yourselves some cold beverage, but don't go too far because we'll be right back very soon. Stay tuned.